In recent times, Singapore has welcomed significantly more electric cars than we've ever had before. In 2022, nearly 12% of all new cars registered were BEVs. That's more than 1 in 10 cars hitting our roads. But not every manufacturer believes that EVs are the only way forward. At least, not battery EVs.
That's why we've flown halfway across the world, all the way to a very special location where BMW is letting us get up close with its latest hydrogen-powered vehicle. Over the last few hours, we've gotten a chance to get behind the wheel, experience some hydrogen-related facilities up close, and most importantly, ponder the question of if or why hydrogen is important.
Before we dive into the car itself, let's talk location. Why Antwerp? Antwerp operates the second largest port in all of Europe, just behind Rotterdam, with a maritime connection to more than 1,000 other ports worldwide. But more importantly, it calls itself an active pioneer of the sustainable hydrogen economy and says that its goal is to become Europe's leading import hub for green hydrogen. It is precisely within this green energy economy for Europe, wherein hydrogen power is shaping up to become an extremely crucial part, that the iX5 hydrogen hopes to slot in.
Coming back to the car now, even though this is supposed to be a test fleet vehicle, more on that later on, we're going to talk about it like a normal everyday car because that's what hydrogen-powered vehicles are supposed to be, right? So if this car looks familiar to you, that's because it is. It's based on the BMW X5. I think one thing to note aesthetically about the BMW iX5 hydrogen is that it follows the pre-face of the X5, so you don't get those chevron or arrow-shaped elements in its headlights, and also the front apron hasn't been redesigned. Having said that though, there are a ton of hydrogen-specific accents just splashed around the car.
In the same way that the iX3 was enhanced over the X3, the iX5 hydrogen gets thorough BMW i treatment all over, just taken to an even further extreme and with its own unique shade of blue. You see this on its front and rear aprons, along its side skirt, in its wheel inserts, and of course around its kidney grille, which is 3D printed. Fun fact, the car does actually emit water vapour due to its fuel cell system, but this is channeled underneath its chassis, so you won't find any tailpipes on it.
Moving on to the inside, we want to start on the rear bench specifically because we want to show you guys this. Well, let me explain. These are not your conventional rear quarters. To make the BMW X5 the BMW iX5 hydrogen, it took the platform of the X5, fitted it with a completely new floor assembly so that it could accommodate the car's new hydrogen tanks. And as a result, you get the hydrogen tanks stored underneath the center tunnel here, and also underneath where I'm seated right now, the rear seats. So the amount of headroom that you get and the amount of legroom that you get is exactly the same as you would get in a BMW X5.
That also means that the iX5 hydrogen suffers no compromises in boot space. You still get as cavernous a trunk as you do on the PHEV car. We'll talk about the car's drivetrain later, but let's hop into the front first.
Alright, in the driver's seat, the first impression you get is that this space feels quite familiarly BMW. It's more previous gen X5 / current gen iX3 than as compared to the BMW's current technological flagship, the iX. So you get these two distinct screens, you don't get the curved display that the iX has. And also the steering wheel and the gear lever are all as with pre-facelifted X5. But there are also very, very cool hydrogen-related accents around, so these little blue accents here are all specific to the hydrogen, iX5 hydrogen, and you also get this hydrogen fuel cell lettering across the front passenger. And fun fact, this little triangle here that I thought it was a triangle, it actually represents a water droplet.
To give you an idea of what's going on beneath the car, we too got a look at the inner workings of it. As mentioned, the fuel cell system located at the front of the car effectively converts hydrogen from the tanks into water and electricity to produce 170 kilowatts of continuous power. And this is supplemented by a power battery at the rear. Interestingly, this electric motor used by the iX5 hydrogen is the same one from the BMW iX, sending power to its rear axle. BMW says that the iX5 hydrogen has a range of about 500 kilometers, which we didn't get to test since our scenic drive was only 85 kilometers long. But more importantly, the whole idea of range anxiety isn't supposed to exist with a car like this. Arguably, the largest selling point of hydrogen vehicles is that they drastically reduce your downtime. With its two hydrogen tanks capable of carrying up to 6 kilograms of hydrogen stored at 700 bar, refilling the car will take only about 4 to 6 minutes, or around the same time as the iX5 that we know.
We are now taking a scenic drive with the BMW iX5 hydrogen from the hydrogen refueling station at the Hafenhaus to BMW Driving Centre in Bornem. And the BMW iX5 hydrogen feels very much like any other EV on the road. You get this very smooth, quiet drive, instant torque, instant acceleration. And also the car is not really trying to tell you that it is a special hydrogen vehicle. It's just trying to make your life very easy with information laid out clearly, just as any other BMW would. One thing to note is that because this was built on the pre-facelifted X5, you get BMW OS 7, so this actually feels more like a traditional BMW in some sense compared to the BMW iX, which had the curved display, the new hexagonal steering wheel. So the BMW iX5 hydrogen has 295 kilowatts of power, which is a combination of the fuel cell system and the electric motor and battery at the rear. The car is rear-wheel driven and produces 396 brake horsepower, which is quite on par with what you get from the plug-in hybrid variant of the BMW X5. And another interesting thing to note is that this weighs around the same as that car, so it's lighter than a comparable battery electric vehicle of this size. And yeah, even the way we stop and the way we take off is just so quiet and smooth and comfortable. So that's the experience of driving that we're getting with the BMW X5 hydrogen.
Ultimately, it may help to see the BMW iX5 hydrogen as a 21st century testbed for now. BMW knows this. The car is being built in limited numbers and it isn't even coming to Singapore. In case you're asking why, the answer is simple. You'll have to travel all the way up to Malaysia to find the nearest hydrogen refueling station to us. But that doesn't mean that fuel cell EVs are a distant part of the future. BMW says that it's targeting a production model by the end of the decade, although it's more likely we'll see this introduced for its larger models. And as for why we in Singapore should care, the government has already pledged that hydrogen will factor in heavily as part of its strategy towards decarbonisation in 2050. That's most certainly to our benefit. If more choices emerge along the way to a greener future, why should we say no?
Alright guys, so that was our experience of the BMW iX5 Hydrogen Days. What do you guys think about hydrogen power? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like and share this video if you've enjoyed it. And also subscribe to our Sgcarmart YouTube channel. Also, we are on TikTok, so follow us at Sgcarmart. And that's all from us from Antwerp, Belgium. Bye!
We are going to put the car into sport mode. And...
whoa, there we go!
Alright, we are now headed towards that building over there to attend a series of workshops about the fuel cell. Alright, again.